Okay, here is a lesson to help you with X-ray attenuation. And you should know something about X-ray attenuation already from doing the communication topic and talking about the attenuation of signals. And if you've already seen it, maybe the work on ultrasound as well. So attenuation is about signals or intensity dropping. So if I were to look at the syllabus now, the syllabus point here is recall and solve problems by using the equation I equals I zero e to the minus mu x. And what we're talking about with I here is intensity. When we're talking about I zero, we're talking about the intensity of the x-rays before it's passed through any of the body or anything else. So after that point, it attenuates, and as it passes through, becomes less and less of a strong thing. And it depends on what the material is and the absorption coefficient of that material. So different materials have different values. So I'm just gonna go through my PowerPoint here. You'll excuse the unprofessional nature of this. So what we're looking to do here, we're learning to recall and use the equation for how the intensity of X-rays vary through a material. And what I'd be looking for here is just the use of the equation to perform calculations, and you can use this PowerPoint, which will be put up, to do the calculations, the usual sort of multiple choice kind of things. We're going to recognize the mathematical skills required to complete problems of attenuation, so I'll do that with some demonstration on paper. So normally we'd be recognizing some patterns that come in papers, as well as just the simple calculations. And then we're going to complete exam questions where x-rays pass through a series of different media. So what we're talking about here, or the example I'll give you, is actually a model of a thumb where you have flesh, then bone, then flesh again. And so I'll do that by just completing that muscle to bone kind of calculation, and I'll demonstrate that. So since we're not in the classroom, let's keep passing on. So it's another example of exponential attenuation or exponential decay. So it's very similar to half-life, which you've seen in nuclear physics this year, and also signal attenuation as well. So as the x-rays pass through the material, they're gradually absorbed, and this leads to attenuation. So we know now the attenuation of x-rays through a material follows the inverse square laws. That means their intensity drops exponentially, and this equation should look fairly familiar. Maybe the actual letters don't look familiar, but the I zero e to the minus mu x is very much like what we're used to seeing with decay curves. Mu is the linear attenuation coefficient. Okay, and x is the distance through the material. So just like we have half-life, we also have half-distance, which is the distance it requires to take the intensity down to half its original value. When you go to the textbook and do some questions on this, on page 510 from the David Tsang textbook, you have question 3, which may look very, very familiar to the nuclear physics stuff that you've done before. So that's what I'm talking about here, that half-thickness value. When you do question 3, you should bring yourself through how you prove that x half, which is the half distance, equals the natural log of 2 over that linear attenuation coefficient. So I've got some graphs to show you some differences of how different materials with different linear attenuation coefficients vary there. The amount they attenuate the material. So I'm going to start here by choosing air. Now, unsurprisingly, air doesn't do a whole lot to the amount that transmits through. So on the y-axis there, we have transmission. That means the amount that passes through the air. So in other words, air barely does anything to it at all. And looking at this graph, it does nothing at all. So let's take a look at and it's got a value nonetheless of mu equals 0.0154, and that would be, and the units of that are, let me just remind myself, something per centimetre. It is, it's just per centimetre, so it's just the amount that attenuates per centimetre. So let's just move to something a little bit more dense. So water, you can see there, has a value of 17.1. So air does attenuate, but it doesn't do very much. And then we have a half distance there of 0.041 meters, which is 4.1 centimeters. It's gone down by half. So which might surprise you. Let's take a look at blood. So these materials obviously are significant in the body. So blood is actually a little easier to pass through for whatever reason. And then we've got a fat here. So there's a layer of fat, obviously, 0.046, just a little more than water and blood. And then we have muscle at 0.039. So just under 4 centimeters, so less dense than water. May surprise you, but the one, of course, that's the most attenuating is bone. So in just 2.5 centimeters, the value has gone down by half. So the bone absorbs a lot of x-rays, and that's why they show up white on your x-rays themselves. So at this point, you could try performing some calculations using that I equals I zero e to the power minus mu x. I'll demonstrate that in part in the exam questions that I'm going to show you in a little while. Okay, and at this point you would also probably be able to do all three of questions 3, 4, and 5 on 5.10 if you gave them a go. I will also post up for you the answers to those so that you can check your answers. Okay, so this video won't be quite so long because it really is all about demonstration. So I'm going to do some exam questions, kind of talk you through those, and hopefully it'll make sense to you.